Here are 9 essential VS Code extensions that you didn't know you needed. The extensions I'll be presenting are slightly off the beaten track. Even though they have loads of downloads already, they're popular, they're free, they're reliable, they're easy to use, they're suitable for all skill levels and programming languages. Above all, these extensions allow me to solve very specific problems. They make my life a lot easier in different ways. They save time and they help me stay in the flow. Let's go through these 9 extensions and the problem they solve. And yeah, there's a bonus at the end. My first problem requires some context to explain. It's related to my long-time work on a website that uses PHP and React and is connected to a MySQL database. At any given moment, I'm working on one of 4 different tasks: long-term development, quick fixes, pushing code out into the world, or running scripts in the production environment. To do these tasks, I have different folders, each containing a copy of the code: the fix, dev, release, and prod folders. But there have been times when I've started working in a VS Code window and suddenly realized that I was working in the wrong folder, or worse, running code on the production database instead of on my local database. I need to be able to tell at first glance what folder I'm working in. Now, this is where Peacock steps in. It has over 3 million installs. It assigns a unique color to each project. I use red for the prod folder, which tells me to tread carefully. Dev is in blue, which is safe. My second problem: I often have to maintain old projects and waste time trying to find where I stored my code on my computer. This is where Project Manager steps in. It has 4.7 million installs. It allows me to manage my projects. I can tag them, I can group them, and more importantly, I can quickly switch between them without navigating my whole file system. My third problem: we use GitHub Actions to prepare our code for release and to check that everything is fine. But GitHub Actions take time. To check their status, I would tend to go to GitHub's website, but switching between contexts is counterproductive. This is where GitHub Actions come in. It has 2 million downloads, and the extension shows me the status of my GitHub Actions within the VS Code editor. It can see which runs have succeeded, and if not, which steps have failed. Now, talking about Git, the fourth problem: sometimes I encounter code that I don't understand, where it isn't clear what the person was trying to accomplish. I could use Git Blame or GitHub's interface to work out the code's history, but again, that requires changing context. This is where Git Lens steps up. This extension has 32 million downloads. It allows us to see in VS Code, when we hover our cursor over a line of code, who wrote the code, when, and in which commit. The fifth problem: documenting your code using comments is essential, but we use comments to communicate very different things, to warn people that a function will be deprecated, to ask a question, or to note a task that needs to be done later. But by default, when you're scrolling through code, it's difficult to say whether a comment is vitally important, whether it's a to-do, or whether it's just a joke. Now, this is where Better Comments steps in. It has 6.8 million downloads. It highlights comments in different colors based on how they're formatted. A comment that starts with an exclamation mark is a warning. One that starts with a question mark is a question. One that starts with a to-do is, well, I'm pretty sure you can guess. And that brings me to our sixth problem. How can you track the to-dos that have been left throughout your code? This is where To-Do Tree steps in. It has over 4.4 million downloads, and it was created by Grunt Fugly, and with a name like that, you know they're British. To-Do Tree allows you to browse your project folder tree to see all your project's to-dos and to take action where needed. Now, our seventh problem is bundle creep. There's a temptation to solve problems by using other people's code. That's a good idea if the problem is complex and outside of our skill set. However, in client-side JavaScript, adding modules means increasing the bundle size and slowing down the page. It's difficult to closely monitor how much your imports weigh. This is where Import Costs comes in. It has 3.7 million downloads, and it displays the size of any third-party bundles in your JavaScript code. In this etapp.tsx file, for example, Import Costs shows that Axios adds 13 kilobytes when zipped, and iitnext adds 15 kilobytes. Now, there aren't any easy native alternatives to i18next, but do I really need Axios now that the Fetch API is widely available? Well, probably not. The import cost extension allows me to see the problem directly within my code. Now, talking about fetching data, our 8th problem is testing APIs. What I like about web and game development is that you interact directly with the result of your work. When you're building web APIs, that's more complicated. Programs like Postman allow you to interact with APIs, but that takes me out of the context of Visual Studio Code. The REST extension solves this. It has 4.6 million downloads. Let me show you how it works. Here, I create a login request. It pulls sensitive information from my environment file, and then I can store the response in a variable and use it to authenticate later queries. And here, because GraphQL uses a POST request to an endpoint, I can run GraphQL requests from here too. I can also use the extension to run requests against third-party APIs, like the OpenAPI ChatGPT API. And now for our 9th problem. When we interact with REST APIs, the data's shape depends on how the API has been implemented. It's tedious to go through a JSON response and convert it to the correct type. Now, this is where our next extension steps in. Paste JSON as code has 2.2 million downloads, and it supports TypeScript, Go, Rust, C++, Python, and many more. So for example, let's open our JSON file, our response, and copy its contents. Now if I open the command palette, and I select paste JSON as types, I'll have a very good starting point for defining the type of the JSON response that I'll be getting. Now, while we're here, this isn't an extension, but I've had several questions from people inquiring about the theme I use in VS Code, and that makes sense because, well, I love the style and the colours. The theme is called Luvia. It's clean, it's simple, and that makes it easier to focus on the code. And the colouring just makes sense to me. Let me know what you think in the comments, or if there are any other extensions that are worth highlighting. And I'll see you in this next video.